if you're taking the October SAT, you need to realize that, you know, you'll have less than a month left, right? So what can you really do to see a genuine improvement in like your practice test to when you take your final exam, right? And specifically about math, what can I do, right? So I never really struggled with math, and I'm going to tell you why. So back in about sixth grade, might have been like 12 or 13, I think, at that time, there was a charter high school, right? And basically you had to take a test to get into that high school. So from sixth to like a little bit through halfway through eighth grade, right? That was when the exam was to get in that high school. I was preparing for it, right? I was preparing like math, English sections. Like it was very similar to like SAT concepts, but obviously, you know, it wasn't the same, but I would practice math problems, and my parents would make me do this, right? They would make me practice a certain kind of problem, and then they make me go over the ones that I got wrong again and again with different examples, right? And this, even though like I don't even know if my parents like specifically thought about that or that was a strategy that they had, but that specifically made me so much better at math. It was the fact that I knew exactly what to target, when to, you know, practice it, and how much I should practice it based off of what type of the mistake it was. So that's like the ideology I used for math in the SAT, and that strategy has been so powerful for me. I literally within 3 months got a perfect on the section and was able to do that on the SAT, right? So I never really struggled with SAT math as a result of this, my practice and my understanding of a strategy to practice, right? Because there can be two people with the same exact amount of time, and the person who has a more effective strategy is going to beat the person with the less effective strategy all the time. So this kind of changed the way I looked at math and math tutoring, and why I don't really see this being talked about today, right? And I could just give you a bunch of garbage tips that are not going to be applicable, but I actually want to help you, right? So this is October SAT Math, how to maximize your score, and I'm Karthik. All right, you have less than a month. So let's keep in mind that every single day counts and we need to take advantage of every single day. So you're going to take a practice exam today or tomorrow, right? And you know, maybe you took one less than a day ago or like 2 days ago, then you can use that as the reference, right? And make sure, like with the math section specifically, because that's the one we're targeting here, use a stopwatch, not a timer. We don't care as much about the fitting the time slot. Unless you already fit within the time and time isn't an issue for you, you can use a timer, sure. But we want to focus on using a method to control like how much time we're spending overall, right? We like want to self-regulate, but we don't want to have that timer because we want to know how long the entire section is going to take us. And we don't want to potentially cut off some questions that, you know, could be of value. We don't want to waste those. So use a stopwatch, not a timer, finish the whole sections and do an answer categorization. This is the most important part, right? What you're going to do is you're going to compile them into these four groups. The don't know group, the know group that you have no idea like how to even begin solving this question. You don't know the concept, you never learned it, right? And then the educated guess. You know some things about it, but not clear enough to fully know the answer. And you lack like an understanding of like half of the problem. So you can't solve it. So you have to educated guess, right? Careless mistake. You fully know the problem and you knew how to get it, but you made a mistake while reading it or like interpreting it or something, right? And then you completely know it, right? You completely know the question. You completely know the answer. And that's like something you don't even have to think about. It's just very easy for you. All right. So now you have your prioritization. What are we doing for every single category? I'm going to go over that now. So the don't know category. This is the thing you should be focusing all your effort on, right? If you have any in this category. If you have any in this category, it's all you should care about, right? Because this is the biggest potential to like get the easiest point. So what I mean by that, it's going to take the least amount of time to see the biggest score improvement for this. So specifically, if you're practicing for the October SAT, in literally 2 days, you could cover all your don't knows and increase, like, let's say you have like 5 don't know concepts, you could increase your score 100 points in 2 days just by learning all of your don't know concepts. If you just learn it, it's that easy. And obviously, you can't magically learn things you don't know. It's not going to just come to you like you're writing some sort of new theory or formula. If you want to learn new things, you have to consult outside resources. I recommend Khan Academy because it's free and you can do it whenever you want, or a person of experience. And that might be really helpful for personalization and such, right? So refer to either someone who knows like about the SAT or refer to like an outside resource like Khan Academy, like any online YouTube video that explains how to do a type of problem, you know, consult those resources. And most of these like questions, right, you want to move to the careless and educated guess like category. You don't want to keep anything in the don't know category for your next SAT because it's so easy to get out, and you want to move it to these higher level categories so you can get a higher accurate percentage. So prioritization, right? Now we're going on to the educated guessing portion, which is, as I explained before, you still have gaps in your learning, but you don't like completely not know the concept. You know a little bit, you reviewed it, you learned it with somebody, and you know most of it, but it's not fully ingrained, right? And you need to focus on learning again, right? You already know it, but if you don't know a certain part of the problem or you like just forgot it, you need to go back and review it. So learn those parts that you don't know, consult the external resources, and the most important part, retest to figure out if you're still in this category. This category is just basically a one up from completely not knowing, but it's not near that level where you fully know. It's in between. So you need to cut that gap and go to the part where like you make careless mistakes, and but you fully know how to do it, and you knew your mistake and it was like a dumb mistake, right? And I'll go into why those are actually still serious mistakes after, but you need to basically just learn more, finalize your learning, and get rid of that learning stage. But this category is still easy points. You're still in the learning stage, and it might not be possible to get everything out of this category as much as it is with the don't knows, but it's still easy points, and it's the easier thing to improve once you've done all the don't know parts and moved it to the educated guessing category, right? Now, careless mistakes, they are still mistakes, right? And think about this. When was the last time you made a mistake doing 2 plus 2, right? When was the last time you accidentally said it was 5 instead of 4, right? How did we get so perfect at doing 2 plus 2? Because we never make mistakes doing 2 plus 2, right? How do we get so perfect? We practiced it so much. Relentlessly, we practice it. Like all of your childhood is probably doing basic addition. That's why we don't mess up doing basic addition. We have so much practice with it. It's ingrained in our heads. Use the same logic for careless mistakes on the SAT. You don't make careless mistakes out of just random chance or happenstance, right? You make careless mistakes as a lack of like extreme review. So you need to do extreme review. And this is a hard thing to get perfect at. But if you do this, you move to the excellent category where you never make mistakes on it, right? So use this logic of 2 plus 2 and never making mistakes on that to promote this idea that the only thing between you and like careless mistakes and getting them completely perfect is this idea that you need to practice the category again and again and again and retest, right? Retest to know if you have moved on or if you're still in the same category. You need to do it frequently. And I'm going to talk more about that later, but just know careless mistakes, it's all about practice, right? So you're going to notice that there might actually be a stage in between careless mistakes and fully knowing where you completely know the type of question. You almost never make careless mistakes, but every once in a while you take a practice exam and you get it wrong. That's completely normal. That's fine. It happens, right? We want to perfect that, and we will if we practice even more. But that's just like if this is the careless mistake and this is the perfection category, you're just in between. You're just, that is what this getting there stage is. And it's normal to be in that stage. It's normal to stay in that stage for a long time. It's just you need even more practice. And this is the hardest thing to improve. It takes the most amount of effort and you get the least amount of points improvement. But if you're aiming for that perfect score, if you're already in the getting there category for every single question type, then you need to improve on this if you want to get a perfect score, if you want to do well on the math SAT, right? It's normal, and you should still go over these on occasion, right? Like go over them, and you should know that like even if you get it right, but you've gotten it wrong previously, go over the question, but your priority should be all the previous like skill gap categories. So here's some final retesting tips. For this method to work, you need to constantly retest. The more practice takes, the better you're going to understand what type of questions you miss, because there might be question types that aren't in one specific SAT, but they are in different ones, right? So if I take like 20 practice exams, right? I take all the practice exams that are available to me, I will know all of my skill gaps, right? I will know every single category that I don't know, or I will know what categories are in what specific gap, right? If it's like the completely don't know, the careless mistake, I will know all of that. So knowing where your gaps are is like the diagnosis, right? You have diagnosed your problem. But practicing and reviewing is curing that problem, right? It's like first you learn the concept, right? That gets you to an expert level, right? And then you practice the concept again and again, and you stop making careless mistakes. And then you do a little more practice and you focus on it again and again. You get to that perfect, right? So learning, practicing, reviewing, that's going to solve the problem depending on what stage you're in. And I can guarantee this, right? If you follow this method from now until your October SAT, you will 100% see at least an improvement, right? As small as it is, you know, you will see an improvement. You will improve your score and it will be different than the practice test you took. You're going to take a couple days from now or the practice test you just took yesterday or the day before. You will 100% improve. Now, if you follow this method for 4 to 6 months and don't give up, I will guarantee that you get a perfect score. If you diligently follow this method with 100% like focus and you do it every single day, I guarantee you will get a perfect score. If you just focus yourself on this method and keep testing, keep practicing, it's going to happen. All right. Thank you guys so much. And I hope you learned something today.